Here we are at the Duds Dome, where the Minneapolis Milk Duds will take on the Provo Polar Bears in tonight's last game of the season for the Pacific Division, for the Masters Division, for the Contenders Division. This ends tonight. We will crown our Western champion here for Season 12. Will it be Provo? Will it be Minneapolis? That's what we're here to find out. Thank you for tuning into the SPL Network. My name is Darth Taxil. This is going to be something that's going to go down in the history books. I hope. I pray. I fathom. This being the best West Finals we've ever seen. The amount of talent, the amount of stacks just oozing with skill on both sides of the ice here tonight. I don't think we're going to be in for a snooze fest. I don't think this is going to be a blowout. I don't think by any stretch of the imagination this is going to be one that you're going to want to miss. Provo Polar Bears 8-4, the third seed, coming into the postseason with a bit of a lackluster ending to their regular season. Of course, the middle, the cream of the Oreo between the sandwich of the Minneapolis Milk Duds, which were the first seed. They were the favorites. They were the President's Trophy winner, if you speak in NHL. But the Minneapolis Milk Duds finishing with a 10-2 season. Everybody in the Masters Division playing everybody three times, as there are only five teams throughout the Masters Division. So you get to see the faces a few times before the end of the regular season. So Minneapolis and Provo, they have played each other a couple of times, and tonight we might see five more games between these two teams. And I don't think it's going to be I think if we get at minimum four games, that's all I can really ask for out of these two hockey clubs. But if you're not familiar with either side of the ice, if you don't keep up with the West Coast of the Slapshot scene, here are the rosters for tonight. The visiting team, the Provo Polar Bears, captained by Speed Chaser once again, fought along by Blue, Pediatric Patrick, and Soccer Boy EJ. Provo are the defending champions from last season, but of course last season they had Fuico. Fuico changing the color of his jersey to brown tonight, going to be out there on the ice with Barbecue and Graves to start this matchup. Cole is on the bench. All four of the players for the 10-2 Minneapolis Milk Duds are in the lobby already. They're ready to rock. They're ready to roll. And so whenever Provo shows up, we will get this one underway. But in the meantime, getting even farther into it, taking a look at our odd shot players to watch. Who are you going to keep your eyes on tonight? I say it's going to be Blue. I say it's going to be Fuico. Two players that were allies last season going to be facing off against each other. Top goal scorer, second, and top goal scorer, number three, only outdone by a single man. And many of you know him well, and that's carried by Dad. Of course, not in the finals here this season, as he was with the Capybaras. They played a fabulous semifinals game against the Minneapolis Milk Duds, but came up a little short. I think it was actually against Provo. Hang on, let's take a look at the bracket. I'm not as caught up on this as I thought I was, but taking a look at the bracket, Provo and Oregon. Oregon just kind of had a bad day. You always have that in Slapshot. Not every day can be your best, and not every day you can give 100%. But tonight, these teams need to do just that. They have five games possible on the board. They need to take home three of them. Fuico, the most decorated Western player in all of Slapshot, seven championships, looking for his eighth tonight. And if Blue can find a way to upset him as the other player to watch for the Provo Polar Bears, he's going to be the goal scorer to watch tonight. If he can do that, he will tie Fuico for most championships. But of course, with the Western Division, we have said if you win five chips in the West, you do get a crown. So Graves right now, right here, playing for the Minneapolis Milk Duds tonight, going to be looking to do that as this next. He has four championship rings. He's looking for his fifth. And if he gets his fifth, he gets his crown. So he's got a lot on the line. He's going to be playing his heart out. He's going to be bleeding a little bit onto the ice, and hopefully we can get that cleaned up. But these are the last two times these two teams met up, and that first game of the season not shown. But of course, all six players ready to rock, all six players ready to roll, and we will not keep them waiting. We're down on the ice. The Provo Polar Bears defend the left cage in the teal. The Minneapolis Milk Duds on the right side in the brown. And as soon as the game capture says it's game time, it will be so. And right from the drop of the puck, finding a backhanded shot right from the faceoff. Fuico showing what he does best. Found a gap in the defense, and that's all she wrote. Oh, they're off to an early lead, and I'm not going to see this slowing down anytime soon. Just one falsehood. Great shot there, but Blue there defends it beautifully. Blue has become one of the most diverse Slapshot players I've ever seen, playing West Coast, East Coast, very professionally, top of the top, cream of the crop. He has played all three positions, something very few players have done in their career. Not even Panarin or Henry have played all three positions throughout their career. He started as the offenseman back with the Maui Monkeys. He switched to a two whenever Kylar wanted to play the offensive side. And so he knows how to play the middle, he knows how to play the offensive side of the puck, and he knows how to play the defensive side of the puck, as he's gotten more comfortable with his ping, more comfortable with his controller. And tonight we're going to see the cream of the crop here for Blue as he passes that one topside, stolen away. Barb finds his way to Graves, and he shoots and scores, and he makes it 2-0. early on. 4:17 to go. So much time left in this game. But there is a 10-goal Mercer rule. If we ever do hit a gap of 10 at any point tonight, the game is called early, and we move on into the next chapter. But an early two goals, finding themselves a way to notch it into the belt here early on. And if it just keeps up, Provo's going to have to stop this bleeding sometime soon. Barbecue finds his way over to Fuica. Pass over to Graves. Graves with one man to beat. Shot wide off to the near side. Here's Blue with it now as he carries that one back down to the near side. He tries to find a step against Graves. Finds it topside to Soccer Boy EJ. Soccer Boy off the backhand. Forehand. Pass back over to Blue. Blue dangling topside. Gets past Barbecue. Shooting. Oh, there she goes. What a beautiful just finesse. Like a grandma quilting a blanket for her grandson. Oh, my goodness. Precision, accuracy, and all-around great slap shot. Good stuff there by Blue. Cutting that lead in half down 2-1. Blue not going to give up. Taking that puck right back. Says the possession is mine. As he leans towards the top side of the ice. The cross ice is open. Takes that step even farther top side as he shoots that one down low. Goes off the end. Well, here's Graves now from Minneapolis. Soccer Boy EJ trying to get a stick lift on him. Graves over to Barbecue. Barbecue, longtime Western player, playing all the way since season 2, I believe. My memory does not mistake me. It might be 3, it might be 4. Who knows? Soccer Boy shooting, scoring. Top shelf where mom keeps a peanut butter. And with 3:18 to go here in the first, we already have 4 goals on the board. Soccer Boy, hard angle shot. Credit where credit is due. Very difficult one to land. We're tied at 2s here in the first. According to the in-game scoreboard, I don't know where my mental math went wrong, but they're finding a way to get it done. Soccer Boy finding a way to break away from that defense. Tie us up there. Here's Fuico off the backhand. Stopped there by Blue. Soccer Boy EJ with a shot blocked away by Barbecue. Goes topside over to Fuico. Fuico here trying to dance through the neutral zone. Simmering that one back down defensively over to Barbecue. Barbecue goes off Graves with a lob down low, hoping for the prayer to be answered, but nobody there was on the end of that call. Topside out to the point to Barbecue. Stick checked away by Soccer Boy EJ. The stick challenge is on his chaser. Getting involved in the battle. Goes topside Fuico out to Graves off the forehand. Not able to let that one rip. As maybe he just got too caught up in the moment. Wasn't expecting to catch that pass. Who's to say what happened out there? But we still remain 2 on the board apiece. Blue taking that cut topside over to Soccer Boy. Soccer Boy pulling, shooting. Oh, what a beautiful shot. And that one is going to leave a mark. 2:29 to go. And Blue with an absolute dime over to Soccer Boy. Catches Barbecue cheating on that one. And that one's going to sting a little bit. 3 unanswered goals for the Provo Polar Bears. And they find themselves on top 3-2. Blue leans topside. Not a whole lot there to work with. He's going to lob it downtown. Not quite able to hit the field goal post on that one. Barbecue, nice reversal over Fuico. Fuico in trouble against the SPL's best enforcer. Heaviest stick to check. Blue here with the puck now goes topside. Stick check there by Graves trying to loosen that one up. Blue not going to back down from that challenge. Soccer Boy there. Moses is on way down the near side. Chase going to keep that one back for the boys in teal. Here's Blue with it now. Blue, the 5-time looking to be 6-time champion. Towards that top side of the ice. Graves getting a piece of that one. Soccer Boy getting a hand on that one. Pops loose over to Speed Chaser. The captain shooting. Goes off Barbecue out of the hash marks. That one goes off Fuico on the way out. He'll keep driving on North. Blue takes it away off the back end. Pass over to Chase. Chase shoots, scores, and it's 4-2. And the Provo Polar Bears are just piling it on like mashed potatoes on Thanksgiving. And they're not slowing down. They're not stopping. They're never saying die tonight. Game one has been a wild one so far, and we still got 1:40 to burn in the first period. Shooting off the side of the cage. Blue awarded that save. Zone comes off the near side and out of the zone. Fuico there tries to give himself some elbow room. None to be found against Soccer Boy EJ. Barbecue over to Fuico or Graves with that shot. Blue then now back behind his own goal, taking his time. Looking to set up the breakout. Looks to lean topside. Fuico there trying to cut across the cross-ice pass and force him down the near side wall. Blue just barely. Oh, my goodness. Holy cow. He's just like the Avatar. He's in his pro state right now, and he's feeling every moment, every second of the ice on the ice is slipping through his fingertips, and he's getting every chance possible, and he's capitalizing on all of them. Soccer Boy, that's going to go in. Oh, no, I don't believe that for a second. Can we get a goal line camera angle fast enough? That is as close as it gets. And it's 6-2 for Provo. Oh, my goodness. The cards are falling down. And that early lead that Fuico gave us is just long gone. Barbecue off the forehand. Finds a little bit of elbow room. Shooting. Nice save there by Blue. Directs traffic off to the near side with that rebound control. 47 remaining here in the first. Chase off the backhand. Goes over to Graves. Great defense there. Sending it to the far side wall. Barbecue trying to pick it up here from Minneapolis. Graves. Off the backhand, looking for Fuego. Stolen shooting. Goes off the cage and wide. Blue almost able to find another sleeping goal. Make it 7-2, if you can believe that. Here's Blue, then now tries to get away from Fuego. Fuego off the backhand, not able to shake that one. Here's Blue. Fans on it. Goes off barbecue. Chase there, able to fend that one back over to Blue. Blue here with it now. Handled there by Fuego. Fuego getting fancy with it. Trying to feel himself. You got to touch the puck to get used to it. And I feel like there's a little bit of rust to be knocked off from these two teams. Nice shot, Graves. Able to find a way to give a little life back into the Minneapolis crowd. Give the fans something to cheer about and something to think about going into this intermission. 6 seconds remain. Our difference is down to 3 thanks to that shot by Graves. Barbecue. I'll try to slam that one over to Graves, and that will be the end of the first period of action. 6-3 our score as we go into this first look at what are the stat lines. And that possession time is a little lopsided for Provo. Buck 30 to 29 seconds. Shots are 8-6. Provo started off slow, but that slowness quickly dissolved into just untapped, beautiful offense. And we'll see if the second period has the same to tell for us. 6 ready to rock, 6 ready to roll. Duds on the right side in the brown, and the Bears on the left side in the teal. With this puck dropped, second period is now underway. Nice shot, better save there by Graves. Quick call to action there. Nice shot, better block there by Fuego out at the top of the faceoff circles. Fuego there sends that one out and soaring, gives his boy some time to breathe, set up his back check, and get reacquainted with their surroundings. Here's Blue. Off the forehand, a set a long distance prayer down for a hopeful Hail Mary. Off the backhand. Oh, what a dangle. And I don't know if Chase got a piece of the man out in front, but Blue, the demon tonight. The man to watch, the player to watch. And Chase getting a stick check against Barbecue leaves that net wide open. 7-3 our score. And that gap is only growing. Here's Barbecue with the puck now. The comeback story is the same as Rome was built. It's one step at a time, one shot at a time. And you got to get that puck on the net, make the goaltender do something. Here's Graves with it now, trying to get a shot in. It's the post, and it goes in. I don't know about that one. Another goal line save that might have been called back if Toronto was real. But, man, oh, so close yet so far. 4 on the board for the Minneapolis Milk Duds with 4:16 to go here in the second. And they got themselves on the boards first and foremost. 2 unanswered goals. We'll see if they can build on it to try to get back in this one. Game one is always a beautiful game if you can get it under your wing, as it's the pacemaker for the rest of the series. And Fuego off the post, empty cage, just an impossible angle off that near side goal line. And if he made that, I would have eaten my hat. But we still sit 7-4, Provo on top with the lead and the possession. Blue trying to draw this one up to the top side off the wall, finds Soccer Boy EJ down low. Going to break that one out in front. Blue there trails after it to the top side wall. Going to ring that one corner to corner, near side to the outer slot to Soccer Boy EJ. EJ to Blue. Blue dangling. Looking for the pass down the straight. Takes a shot and set. Off we go. Oh, what is it? I don't understand. I don't get it. It's so fast. I can't understand what's happening. But the players see it. The puck just fell in Soccer Boy EJ's lap. I think I goal 5. Slap shot is a strange thing. It truly is. My goodness. It's always full of surprises. Sometimes the servers work, sometimes they don't. Sometimes you get a beautiful goal like that. Man. Barbecue looking top side to bring this one down low for the boys in brown. Off the backhand, out to the point. Fuego with a shot. Nice block there by Blue. Award of the save. Goes out to the near side. Here's Graves dangling, shooting. Oh, what a save by Blue. Stacking the pads out at the top of the... And that one goes in. Oh, the instant counterattack from Speed Chaser himself, the longtime Eastern native. Recently moving to the West Coast, played 2 seasons, has a championship under his belt, and says, you know what, I'd like another. He's got an East Coast chip, a West Coast chip. He's not done yet. I can see the fire in his heart for this game, and I think we'll get at least a few more seasons out of him if the stars do align that way. Here's Fuico off the forehand, shooting, scoring, and just like that, they're just going blow for blow. All gas, no breaks here tonight. 5-9 the score, Minneapolis getting themselves picked up by their bootstraps and getting back within this one. I don't know how I'm getting messed up on the scoreboard. My rust is showing. I'm so enthralled with this game. Beautiful display of slap shots so far here tonight. And if the servers hold up, I hope we get way more of this. Here's Blue with it now. Looking near side off the wall. Looking for the centering pass. And that goes in off the backside of Barbecue. And that's goal 10 for the Provo Polar Bears. And Blue once again just adding to his illustrious offensive game so far. Playing the 3 leads the team in goals here tonight. And he's just going to keep doing what he does best. SB Blue. Dabba-dee-abba-dai. 2:20 to go here in the second. Blue driving down. Pass to soccer boy EJ. Stick check there by Fuico. EJ getting that one right back. Here's EJ for the boys in teal. Looks near side with a Chicken Man costume looking like Al from Toy Story. For those 12 of you that know what I'm talking about. Nice shot scoring, and he finds another. And everybody on the ice that wears a teal jersey can hit the net from any spot possible, and it is impossible to defend. Blue's stick possession, his puck possession, his stick checking, unmatched. Soccer boy shooting so far, near perfect. And Speed Chaser, the compliment, the salt and the pepper to the dish, really complimenting his boys, letting them play their best game, taking away the passing lanes, applying the pressure, making the shots difficult. And you need that in a game. It's not always about the stat columns. Graves, oh, he finds a way to just sit in a scoring opportunistic spot, just like the goal scorers in the NHL, sitting right out in front of the crease, waiting for the puck to come to him, tucking it to bed. 6-11 now on the board. 1:44 to go here in the second. Barbecue taking up the mantle. Looking out to the top side for a bank pass over to Fuico. Almost stolen there by Speed Chaser. That stick lift bank brought back over to Barbecue. Goes off Blue. Back to the point. Barbecue takes it. Shoots it. Nice block. Goes off the top side. Hits the side of the cage from Fuico's shot. Cycled back out to the point. Here's Barbecue. Down center lane. Stick checked away there by Chaser. Here's Graves. Shooting. Nice save by Blue. Zone comes back down around behind the goal line of Provo. Blue able to find EJ. Back over to Blue. Blue here giving a lot of elbow room to work with. Graves the first man up to bat to try to force him one way nor the other. Got a stick check in, but not able to get the puck off of him. EJ down low. Cycles that one topside over to Chase. Chase, 1 minute to pass it to, and that's the Blue. Blue from the red line. Bobbles it. Graves pulling. Shooting. Ah, what a save there. Quick to the challenge. EJ taking up all of the goal on that one. As the shot was literally 3 feet away from him. Here's EJ. Forehand. Tips it towards the cage, but not on. Chase and Fuico now battle for it. Down the near side. Out towards the point, but not able to get it through. Graves to Barbecue. Leading pass to Fuico. Blue, the first man to it, though, takes it away. Off the forehand. Shooting! Nice save by Barbecue. Directs that one to the top side here. Speed Chaser with it now for the Provo Polar Bears. Hits the hip of EJ. Chaser going to knock that one loose topside with 30 seconds remaining. Graves to Barbecue. Barbecue off the backhand. Fed past Graves. He wants that one back. I can see it in his eyes and in his soul. 20 seconds remain here in the second period. Fuico takes it away. Wants to get one more on the board to bring us back closer within 5-4. Math. Blue, 10. Nice shot. Better block there by Fuico. Graves there tries to win the stick-checking battle. Blue wins it away. Goes off to Graves. Here's Fuico. 3 seconds remaining. Not able to get the shot released. Great, great defense. Great back-checking. Great hockey so far tonight here for the Provo Polar Bears. Leading 11-6 into the second intermission of Game 1. We're playing the whole series here tonight. If you haven't watched the Slapshots playoff game before, we played the whole series out in a single night. We get it out of the way. We get it under the rug. You only have to schedule once with this team as there's peppering shots on goal. 17 shots for Provo. 14 shots for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. And we're going to see a lot more. We got 5 more minutes in game 1 between these two teams. Period 3, ready to rock and roll. Maybe the players might show up eventually. It's 11-6 at the end of 2. And that is unfortunate. Man, it was going so well, too. It happens. Slapshot is a slapshot does. Sometimes slapshot, it'd be whack. Sometimes the players just fail to load in. It's a server issue, but, you know, it is what it is. That is unfortunate. And so while I remake the lobby, what'd you guys have for dinner tonight? Did anything good? I personally had some hamburger helper. Very fancy stuff. My mom knows how to cook it up right. And, great stuff. I haven't had anything yet. What are you doing, Messiah? Go get you some food. Pizza. Pizza's a solid choice. I'll never forget the first time I had vegetable pizza, and I thought, wow, I might eat this again at some point. That was my takeaway for it. But yeah, take a quick look at the stats. We will not have a summary at the end of the third period as we had to reset the lobby, so therefore the stat parser will not work correctly. So take a snapshot, take a mental image while you still can. I heard Laugh Track once wrestled a Baron 1. You'd be correct. That is a true story. Six players on the ice, ready to rock, ready to roll here in the third. We'll be keeping track of this score manually up in the booth, and if we hit the 10-goal Mercer roll, we'll figure it out later. Here's Blue with the puck now. Off the forehand, stopped there by Graves. Graves here looking to dangle it onward. I don't think we're going to hit the 10-goal Mercer roll, if I'm being honest with you, quite frankly, and just be straight shooting with you from the hip. But both these teams playing their hearts out, playing the feud like Steve Harvey here tonight, some might say. Barbecue here with the puck, looking to do just that with a pass over to Fuico. Fuico, stick check there by Speed Chaser. Chase takes it away off the back and shooting, hits the post, and that goes wide. Here's Barbecue. Barbecue looking to just outdo, and he does. Oh my goodness, look at him go. Oh, he puts the gravy on. He lathers it on there. He knows what the people like. And Fuico finishing it off. Beautiful play by the Minneapolis Milk Duds. Able to capitalize when they need it most. Goal 7 on the board here in the third. They're just playing it out. They know how to draw it up. They know what to think. They're getting the game plan together. They had a long intermission to talk about it. Go over on the whiteboard what they're going to do, how they're going to beat this team. I think they have a little something. A little ace of spades up their sleeves, some might even say. Blue. Down towards the near side, a forehand shot goes off. Fuico and deflected wide. Here's Speed Chaser with it now. Chase at the blue. Blue polling, shooting. Oh, what a save there by Barbecue, keeping that one wide. Sent off to the near side over to Speed Chaser. Forehand down low, finds his way to EJ. EJ, far side outer slot. Takes that one down low for a ride. Barbecue there, stick checking him, forcing that one free. Fuico and Chase fight along the near side wall, out to the red line. Here's Blue with it now. Stopped there by Graves. Down low to Speed Chaser in the corner of the Minneapolis zone. Graves, Blue, off the backhand. Blue challenged there by Graves, forcing him for a shot attempt. Fuico takes it away, shimmies that one down low like it's shuffleboard. And it's now 8-11. They're breaking it back one step at a time. Graves not stealing it away. The man has valor, and he's not going to steal that one away from Fuico. 2-0 on the period, 8-11 on the game here in game one. And the shot total is about as even as you can get without it being tied or being one closer. I guess math also applies here. Off the backhand, that one goes wide. Graves here looking to pick that one up off the backhand. Off the side of the cage, over to Chase. He shoots, scores. Long distance shot, solid connection. Goal 12 on the board for the boys in teal. With 3:07 remaining, he just found an empty gap in the defense. That fade away from downtown does not miss. Blue looks topside. Fuico there looking to take it away. Soccer boy EJ handles that one back to his carrier. Blue with a shot. Nice block there by Barbecue. Once again, standing tall back between the pipes. That shot goes off. EJ over to Grave. Shooting hits the post. Goes off to the near side wall. Fuico cycles it out to the red line. Barbecue sends it back down to Fuico. A little hot potato back over to Barbecue. T breaks out to the far side. Nice shot. Better block there by Chaser into the far side corner. Graves picks it up near side out to the point. Fuico with a shot goes off. EJ and Chaser going to send this one out for the Provo Polar Bears. Back down in the Minneapolis zone. Here's Fuico with it now. Dudge trailing 8-12. Nice shot there by Graves from the point. Just not quite able to get it on. Here's Fuico back at the point. Down low to Barbecue. Out in front goes off Chase. He'll maintain possession down to the near side wall. Here's Graves. Takes it away. Shot made. Nice block there by Blue. Down along that near side crease. Back out to the point. Here's Barbecue in the neutral zone. Barbecue down low. Graves picking it up at the faceoff circle. Looking to Deacon. EJ hits him. He'll cycle it back over to Barbecue. Barbecue looking down the near side. Stosses that one down low. Off the end wall over to Graves. Topside faceoff circle. Not able to get that one to shoot it. Not able to get that shot on target. Here's Fuico down low. Looking to get that one out in front. Blue there defends that nicely. Back to the end wall. Here's Blue with a buck 58 to go here in the third. Blue near side. EJ empty cage. Pass out in front. Stolen away by Graves. Three, almost a 3-on-2 here from Minneapolis. Shooting, scoring. Top left corner. And that was a beautiful shot. The puck had eyes. And they had eyes for Graves. Fuico playing a little mayhem. Playing a little chaotic card. Back out on the defensive end for the Provo Polar Bears. Getting a few stick checks there on Blue. Throws him off his shot lane. Nice shot there by Fuico. Defends nicely there by Blue. So returns back down to the far side. EJ, nice shot. Better block there by Barbecue on the far side slot. Far side slot. I know what I'm talking about. Barbecue, shot made, goes off Blue. Top side. Defends that one out to the wall. Here's Graves driving in. Nice stop there by Blue. He takes possession with a buck 25 to go here in the third. Blue, down low. Chase. Taking it up, back out to the point. Here's Blue. Blue dangling. Looks for the backhand shot. Barbecue getting a hand on that one. Did something happen? Was there like a glitch in the matrix down there? I saw something happen graphically. I just don't know what it was. I blinked. And that one hits the post. Fuico wanting a mulligan on that one. Here's Blue. Has the lead by three. I don't know if they know that. They just see the scoreboard says 3-1, and they're just keeping it mentally. Both teams have a player on the bench. Both teams have four players, as it is the West Coast. So they have four players on the roster. Both subs are in the lobby, so I'm sure that's their task right now, is to keep track of what the actual score is live on the ball. 40 seconds remaining in regulation. Graves there with the backhand chip towards the cage, defended there by Speed Chaser. Feigns on it. Here's Fuico. Fuico down low, tries for the centering feed, gets it out in front. Here's Graves, taken away. Now it's stick checked away by EJ. Challenge there by Barbecue to keep him on the far side wall as he cycles it back defensively. Back over to Blue for Provo. Here's Blue looking to start this breakout towards his own blue line. Leans near his side. Tries to cut back in front. Barbecue there taking that one away off the back and shooting off the body of Blue on the way through, and that one goes wide. Fuico shooting, scoring, and he makes it 10-12. 12 seconds remain in regulation. Two goals are possible. It is a non-0% chance this happens, but it is a very, very low likelihood that it does. No, okay. 7 seconds remain. Blue. Chase to EJ. And a save by Barbecue to end off the third. I was scared. I'm going to be honest with you. I thought for sure I somehow jinxed it. 22 goals were scored in this game. And here are the third period stats. The goal column will be right. Everything else will only be for the third period. So if you want to do the math yourself, you are more than welcome to. I will not take that pride away from you. My shots say it was 20-21 in favor of Provo. Do with that what you will. But three goals for Fuico, one for Graves. Barbecue playing a great defensive game. Five saves for that man back on the defensive side. Blue played the 200-foot of hockey quite well. Had an insurmountable amount of goals. For sure led his team in terms of that, even though we don't have the official stat lines here tonight. But hopefully game two we have a little bit better server luck, if I'm being quite frank with you. I'm hoping for the best. Six ready to rock, six ready to roll. We're down on the ice here for game two. Provo, again, defending the left cage, attacking to the right in the teal, and on the right side in the brown, we have ourselves the Minneapolis Milk Duds. Clean five on the clock. Pucks drop, the game's on, and everybody is lagging out. So we'll go right back. Hooey. Look at us go. All right. Six ready to rock again. Six ready to go. Here in game two, Provo defends the left cage in the teal. Duds defend the right side in the brown. And I think everybody's fine. So we're going to let this one play out. Barbecue, top side, off the forehand. Stopped there by Speed Chaser right at the faceoff drop. Here's Fuico, down low, Graves. Graves, Duds looking fierce, looking mighty, looking tall. And that one's going to bounce towards the cage. Won't be on, though. Soccer Boy EG, the final point of contact, might have been awarded that shot. But, game says no. Fuico shooting, posting, out it goes. Soccer Boy EJ quick to the draw, finds it off the forehand, shooting, hits the post again. Now it comes back out to Barbecue. Barbecue here with a 2-on-2 chance, pass over to Graves. Graves here trying to beat Blue in a foot race. He finds a way to get past both him and Speed Chaser. Dangles out in front. Oh, the finesse. He's got the puck on the string, and he's showing us what he's got here tonight. Blue, forehand, down low, just getting this puck down in deep. Get pucks in deep, get pucks to the net. That's how you win hockey games. If I've ever watched any NHL interview, that's all you will hear. And that much is true in the slap shot. Nice save there by Graves. Goes off to the near side. Here's Blue with it now. Blue, challenged by Graves. Gets that one near side north. Goes off to Chase. EJ, back in, scoring. Oh, he found a way to get it through. Fuico, the last man back, able to get that one going, but not able to get it going that way. Maybe it's a hitbox. Maybe it's a miscalculation. Maybe it's just a slap shot. I think it's just a great shot. Personally, in my opinion. do what you will with that info. Here's Chase. Down low. Pass out to EJ. Hits the tip of the stick. I can't believe his reaction time. He's like a feline down there. 100 milliseconds. I think if my mind is correct and my frames are above three, was his reaction time for that attempted catch of the pass. Barbecue getting a hand on this one. EJ going to continue his crusade down low in the corner of the dud zone. Barbecue gets it out. Fuico there tries to keep it going northways. Here's Blue with an out. Goes off the forehand with a shot. That one's blocked away by Minneapolis' defense. Here's Blue. Blue at his own goal line. Playing with some fire. Look like Crooks from the Ocean City Typhoons once upon a time. Dangling it out in front of his own cage. Here's Speed Chaser with it yet again. The former Orlando Otter himself doing work down low. Goes off Blue over to Chase. Chase here tries to get a shot lane opened up. Lined up. Trying to get that one putted down the green. Not quite able to get there in time. Blue, great stick check. Gives himself the lead in the foot race. Challenged by another dud on the far side. Gets that pass out to the neutral zone, but nobody in teal jersey. Almost able to swing that one in. Fuico almost finding a way to smack that out of midair. Would have probably gone over the goal if my mind does not deceive me. And that would have been a heartbreak. That would have been everywhere in the Discord. And maybe even farther beyond. Maybe even on ESPN 7 or whatever they're up to now. Blue, top side. Looking to break this one down. Looking split. Goes off. Fuico, near side over Speed Chaser. Graves here tries to fight this one free off the near side wall. Gets it off the hip to the stick. Blue takes it right away. It's like taking a baby. Or however that phrase goes. Here's Blue. Stop by Fuico. Fuico challenged by Chase. Quick. Goes off EJ down low. Barbecue top side. Looking for Fuico with a leading pass. Goes off to Blue. Blue off the backhand. Forehand. Shooting. Near side and wide. Soccer boy EJ just trying to open up that goal crease as much as possible. For Blue. Just a hair wide off to the near side. Here's Blue with it now. Trying to get this one topside to correct the wrongs. Goes off Barbecue there with that block. Goes topside over to Fuico. Fuico pulling, shooting. Near side and wide. We're still 1-0. If you can believe that. At this point, last game, we had at least 10 goals. This game, they're feeling each other out. They're not taking any chances. They're not giving each other an inch, let alone a mile. Provo's got one shot to ring true so far. Here in the 2 minutes, or the 3 minutes, 30 seconds we've played here in game two. Here's Barbecue with it now. Leans down to the near side, goes over to Graves. Graves back out to Barbecue. Barbecue, Fuico, topside. Not able to get that shot on goal. Here's Graves with it now. Graves at the near side, face-off circle. Stick checked away by EJ. Back to the point. Here's Barbecue. Just forces his way through two players. Not able to beat Blue on the backhand shot. Chase always able to swing it out of midair with the baseball back backhand. Graves there with an attempted shot. Goes wide off the near side. And we remain scoreless from both scoring chances. Here's Blue with now 60 seconds remaining in period one. Blue gets too fancy with it. Barbecue goes off. Speed Chaser with that shot. Chase will direct that one topside along the wall. Barbecue down low looking for Fuico. Return fire. Goes off Chase over to Blue. Blue down low at his own end wall. Starts to break out mightily. Near side off the window. Finds EJ back to the neutral zone as Blue take it up at his own point. Blue crosses that red line with a lofted pass over to Speed Chaser. Not able to catch it out of orbit. 35 seconds remaining here in period one of game two. Barbecue takes up the mantle. Looks to make the most out of it. Topside off the bank pass. Fuico out in front. Graves pulling, shooting. Oh, what a save off the tip of the stick. The very last hangnail of the blade. Blue able to stand tall and keep the score intact for the Provo Polar Bears. 16 seconds remain. The shots are even. The score is not. EJ looking to make that one even bigger. That one gets back over to Blue. Blue backhand shooting it. Oh, off Fuico. And what a save on the goal line. Oh, my goodness. Blue from the other end making a save of his own. Hugging that post off the near side. And we go into the first intermission with a 1-0 game. And what a defensive praise to both sides of the ice there in the last 30 seconds. Absolutely immaculate slap shot. 4 shots to 3. Provo have gotten the majority so far here tonight. And if the servers hold up, my golly, we're in for a treat. Soccer Boy EJ, the lone goal scorer so far here tonight. Blue, 3 of the 3 team saves. And on the other side, Fuico with 2. Braves with 1 for the total of 3 saves for them. 6 ready to rock, 6 ready to roll. We're back down on the ice here for period 2 and game 2. Minneapolis Milk Duds in the brown on the right side. Provo Polar Bears left side in the teal. Puck is dropped, the game is on, and we're back underway here in this series tonight. Goes off Blue. Top side off the backhand. That one goes just wide off the far side. Here's Barbecue with it now. Pass over to Graves. Graves lofts that one down low. Barbecue or Blue awarded that save, strangely enough. Looks to direct this one down towards the near side. Forehand over to Chase. Chase pulling out the EJ. Shooting on! That one goes in. He's got both of them here tonight, and he's not stopping. Just sitting on the near or the far side slot. hits Flika right between the eyes, but that hitbox says, nope, that one gets by you. I don't know how it works. Don't know how it happens. Slapshot it is, as Slapshot does. With 2-0 on the board, Provo getting the better side of chances so far here tonight. Here's Flika trying to force his way through the opposition barbecue. Shooting goes off blue. And he's awarded that save as he breaks it out the other way. Nice shot. Better save there by Barbecue off the near side post. Graves trying to get that one on the far side. While Blue there off the back end. Finds a pass over to Speed Chaser. Down low for the boys in teal. No options open as EJ going to loft that one down to the near side. And here's Graves with it now for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. Chase keeping that one down low. Barbecue there. Looks to carry the mail near side. Looking to deliver the package wherever is needed. Off the back end through EJ. Chase gets a hand on that one. Lobs that one down low. Goes off Barbecue in transition. Someone's handed off over to Graves. Graves here from Minneapolis. Topside off the window. Down low to Fuico. Fuico here tries to back pass that one. Gets it back over to Graves after the second try. They play a little hot potato. Goes over to Barbecue. Shot wide off to the far side. Down low in the corner. Here's Graves out to the point. Here's Barbecue. Back at his own blue line. Taking possession down the near side. But stomped away quickly. Extinguishing the flame that might have been there. Graves takes it. Back in forehand. Not able to get Blue to bite on anything. Beautiful defense off the post from the point. And Fuico. Just going to be thinking about that one here tonight. Fuica down low. Hansels that one over towards the near side. EJ back over to Blue. Blue, forehand pass, goes over to EJ. Barbecue gets a hand of that one over to Graves. Graves back towards his own blue line. Tries to get a few swings of the bat in there. Not able to make contact with soccer boy EJ. That one goes over to Speed Chaser. Barbecue gets a hand on that one down low. Blue taking it right back for the Polar Bears. Near side, off the wall. EJ going to loft that one back down low for the boys in teal. Here's Blue with it now. Blue, off the forehand. Chase going to swing at that one, not able to hit it. Barbecue gets a hand on it. Fuico there, fights for it. Blue going to take it back in the neutral zone. Goes off the back end. Just gets past Fuico. That's happened 4 times so far this series. Nice shot, better block there by Barbecue. Follows the shot as well to keep that one off to the near side corner. Here's Blue with it now. Shooting goes off Fuico and wide. Here's EJ. Down low, looking for the pass over to his captain. Here's Chase with it now. Backhand shooting. Easy save there for Graves. Very slap one-esque shot. His Graves shot goes off the near side netting. Here's Blue with it now. With 2:15 to go here in the second. Shot made blocked there by Fuico. Fuico banks that one off the boards and down the full 200 foot of ice. Here's Blue. Off the backhand over to EJ. EJ off the backhand. Not able to get that one out in front. Good stop there by Barbecue. Defending that one down the near side wall. Here's Graves. Not able to get it in the air. Stolen away by soccer boy EJ. Here's Blue. Bank pass back over to the sender. EJ down low in enemy territory. Trying to find a way to fight it out in front. Here's Blue at the red line. Shooting. Goes over to the hands of EJ. A little slap pass right there. Had me fooled. Here's Speed Chaser. Shooting. Nice save there by Fuico. Keeping that one clean to the near side. Down the straight goes over to Barbecue. Barbecue from the outer slot. Stick check there by EJ on the shot release. That'll be corralled in the corner by Blue. Blue taking his time. He's earned the respect that he's been given down there on the ice. The amount of space he has whenever he first gets the puck is just respect. And I don't think you can summarize that any other way than that. The buck 20 to go here in the middle chapter of game two. Blue looks to get the step on Graves down the near side wall. Fuico there to help his mate out. He'll handle that one back off the Barbecue. Barbecue goes off Chase. Here's EJ. EJ, danger zone. Goes off the backhand of Barbecue. It'll be sent back into the neutral zone. Here's Blue. Then now Graves there with a little spinorama, a little Beyblade action. Trying to get that shot on target. Will do it. And Fuico almost able to corral it off the body. But not quite able to get that on target as it just barely goes past the far side post. Here's Blue with it now. Trying to fight his way back out into the neutral zone. Has a 2-on-1 here for the Provo Polar Bears. Fakes the pass. Shoots and scores. I don't know how he hit that angle. Oh, my goodness. His first goal here in game two. Absolutely magnificent with Graves just sitting back. Maybe should have challenged. But it's Blue. What are you going to do? You push out, he just deeks. You stay back, he shoots. And then that happens. 40 seconds to go. 3-0 our score. The Provo Polar Bears showing why they won the championship last season. And they might be doing it again here in season 12. Nice block there by Blue. Graves here with it now. Dangles out in front. Goes out the hands of Chase. And that is going to be Minneapolis' first goal of the series. Or of the game. In the second game of the series. And, you know, all you need is one. You just need one to break the dam. 27 seconds to go here in the second. They got a little bit of something good to take back in the locker room with them, and that might go a long way. You got it. This is a game about confidence. It's about prowess. It's about how you carry yourself, what you believe you can do, and EJ believes he can score a goal, and he's done that 3 times here in the second game. The score is 4-1. And they got a trio coming off the tip of that man's stick. 14 seconds remain here in the second. Net gap is back to three. Chase out in front. EJ not able to take it on the curve of the blade. Hits the tip of the stick instead. Nice shot off the post, and that's going to be a save. So we go into the second intermission with a 4-1 game. Provo on top yet again here tonight. The Duds Dome going to be a home for a heartbreak for one team, and hopefully it's not for the home fans because they paid for the tickets and they paid for the seat. They paid for the whole seat. They're only using the edge here tonight. 4-1 is the goals. 13-9 are the shots. The saves are about even, but that possession time about the same as we saw coming out of that first intermission. I think it was a 1:30 to 30 seconds. 2:28 to the other side's 1:20. That second period, way more even. Minneapolis is going to be starting this third period looking to change something, looking to get more aggressive. They have turtled all game, and they've held the opposition to a 4-goal sum. We'll see if they can do that and score a few goals here in the third, or else this series is going to be mightily harder to come back in. Wico, ready to get that one back to Barbecue. Hits EJ in the process. Play a little Plinko machine action down low. Barbecue sending that one low to Fuico. Not able to hit him. Bank pass from Blue to Speed Chaser. Barbecue will take that one right back. Barbecue off the near side point finds Fuico. Fuico off the near side point finds his way back to the red line. Here's Barbecue down low to Graves. Graves forehand shot goes off to the near side wall as Fuico remains in possession with the Minneapolis Milk Duds. Barbecue shot defended there by EJ Graves. Gets it back out to the point. Here's Barbecue with a now down low. Graves shooting goes off the far side and wide. Off the end wall finds Fuico at the near side faceoff circle. Goes for a shot. Goes out in front of the crease but not able to get the shot released as the puck just didn't work with him to give him the angle. 4:09 to go here in the third. 4-1 our score. Duds down. Looking to come back. EJ knocks it loose. Fuico back between his hash marks. Going to take it up to the top side. Graves with a shot blocked away there by Blue. About 12 feet out from his own crease to stop that shot and challenge the shooter. Blue here with possession for Provo. Goes topside from the red line. Chaser able to find a way to get that one to Plink off the face of Barbecue. He'll take that possession down the near side wall. Looking for the cross ice pass. Chase takes it away off the backhand. Shooting! And that one goes off Soccer Boy EJ. No save award there for Barbecue. 3:38 to go here in the third. Barbecue here with the puck now down low over to Graves. Graves off the hip of the defenseman. Goes back out to the neutral zone. Here's Barbecue with it now. Indianapolis looking to get back on the board. Get things going early. You got to score one to score two, and you got to score two to score three. I've learned that from Tenacious D, if I've learned nothing else in my life. Here's Graves with the puck now. Goes topside over to Fuico. Fuico dangling down low off the end glass, finding its way off the hands of Graves. Over to Barbecue. Soccer Boy EJ. Dangerous pass. Bobbled there by Speed Chaser. Forehand shot. Blue there with the save. That one might be the one that keeps this team in this game. If we only get the 4-3 score at the end of the game, that's going to be the moment that comes back into the freshness of the minds of the fans at home as a capital save there by Blue. Blue here with an out forehand shot. Goes off the body of EJ on the deflection. Fuico standing tall. Here's Graves. Goes off EJ. Blue to EJ. Backhand pass and Speed Chaser just has to walk it in, and he does just that. He does not miss those. And it is now 5-1. The man sporting the 16 on the back of his jersey, making it a lot more difficult for the Duds, but what is not a great comeback story if it is not adversity? Graves going to tuck that one to bed, and it is now 2-5. Fuico is getting that one down low, and we don't get to see the replay. That's fine. It's okay. I didn't want to watch it. It's whatever. Duds said we're down to business. Spectators don't get a say if we skip the replay or not. It's not Rocket League. And so the players want to play, and we'll let them play. As that floating head from Rick and Morty once said, we'll see what they got. Graves dangles out in the front. Here's Blue. Backhand pass, and EJ going to miss that net off the near side from a shot back at the top of the faceoff circles. Barbecue looking to get this one out. Not a whole lot of options. Opened up shooting, scoring, and it's now 6-2. I can't do math. 5+1 was too difficult for me. I don't know what to tell you. Blue, great shot. Empty cage. Fuico, the last man back, just had to pray. The Duds are going to have to play aggro. They're going to have to play with a little thorn in their side, a little chip on their shoulder, and that's going to open them up defensively, and Provo's going to take advantage of that every step of the way that they can find open. Fuico looking to bring this one back over to Barbecue. Barbecue. Sucker punch there by EJ, sent near side out to Speed Chaser. Chaser going to handle that one back defensively over to Blue. Blue here with it now. Looking off the backhand down low. EJ shooting, goes off the crossbar and down. Great save there by Fuico. Blue at the blue line. Looks down the near side wall. Graves. Trying to pencil that one down towards the near side to get this one out of the zone. Here's Blue with it now. Blue dangles past Suico. Forehand pass looking for Chase. Stolen away by Barbecue. So he takes up the mantle. Topside forehand shot goes wide off the end wall. Here's Fuico back out to the point. Here's Barbecue from the red to the blue. Down low to Fuico in the corner. Hits a weird bounce on the wall. Don't know what that was. That's going to cost a goal. I really don't know what that bounce was. That is the strangest thing I've ever seen in my life. God? Is God in chat? I don't know. That's weird. Never seen that before. I'm sure plenty of people have seen that in chat because they play this game way more than me. But I've personally never seen it. 2-7. Dud's looking to bring it back with a minute to burn here in regulation. And the hockey gods are just not – I don't know what they did during their pregame. But the hockey god Jeremy is just not happy with the Minneapolis Milk Duds here tonight. 8-2 the score. I think this one's over. 46 to go. 10-goal Mercer roll coming within four goals. Might see it, might not. There's a lot of scoring to do. Blue used the call puck hotkey. That has to be what it is. There's no other explanation, Jonald. It has to be what it is. That's what it felt like. That's just the aura that it emitted. And 0-9 on the board. Playing the stat game. Never give up, never say die. That goes for both teams. Every number on your card during the finals is a huge number that it will be respected no matter what. Because whenever the day is done, whenever everybody goes to bed at night, they're not going to ask how. They're not going to watch the VOD. They're going to ask how many. What were your stats in the finals? And all six of these players, all eight of these players in the lobby know that full and well. They've been in lobby chat at least twice in their life, and that's all you really need. That will do it for I Saved by Fuico. That will do it for Game 2. The Provo Polar Bears going up in the series with a 9-2 victory over the Minneapolis Milk Duds in the Duds Dome. Provo might have been the third seed coming into the playoffs, but they have not backed down, and they have only put up reasons why they're the best. They play their hearts out. They play their guts out. And they have played some great slap shots so far. Blue, 3 goals. Chase with 2. Soccer Boy with a hat trick plus 1. On the other side of the ice, Graves getting both goals for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. Game 3, ready to rock, ready to roll. The boys are not wasting any time. They don't want to think about it. They don't want to sweat it. They don't want to even nern on it for a moment. So we're right back down at it. Minneapolis Milk Duds once again defending the right cage in the brown. On the left, we have the Provo Polar Bears in the teal. If you're just tuning in, last season, the Provo Polar Bears were able to win the championship. And some of the roster are playing against each other tonight. Fuico on the right side of your screen, and he finds it. He just does it. He's the man. He's the myth. He's the legend. He's the odd shot player to watch here tonight. The season 11 champion carrying his team on his back. And that first goal is going to go a long way here tonight, as that's their first lead since, I think, game 1, period 2 is when it went away. The last season, the Provo Polar Bears won the championship. Speed Chaser Blue and Fuico were the 3 on the ice for that. And tonight, Fuico wearing a brown jersey, Blue and Chaser once again back for Provo. But with Soccer Boy EJ. Soccer Boy EJ kind of making himself known on the East Coast with the Oregon Capybaras as well as the Challenger team. And he's made himself a prolific name towards the higher ranks of the East Coast. Nice shot there. Defended beautifully off to the far side with Provo's first shot being from Blue. That one lofted down low by Graves over to Fuico. Fuico with a shot. Nice block there by Blue. As he looked down low, Graves off the stick of Soccer Boy EJ over to Blue. Blue. Okay, get that one free. Graves, they're getting a hand on this one, looking down towards that near side as he takes it from the corner. Blue starts the breakout. To EJ. Really just trying to find a little bit of elbow room to work with. Barbecue giving him none of that. Minneapolis has the lead. They need to hold on to the puck. That's something they didn't have in game 2. It was the possession time, was the time one-on-one with the puck. Ask it what its favorite color is. They just didn't have the chance to do that. They were just, as soon as we get the puck, we have to send it down, we have to shoot, we have to score, we don't have time for questions. But now, we have some time to sit back. As what's the guy's name? The old 2-9er, Phil Bork. As Phil Bork once said, every team loves to play with the lead. And I don't disagree with him by any shot of the imagination. You have the lead, you feel comfortable, you have more of a chance to open it up, more chance to get the passing lanes down, play more risky. Because if you get scored on, you're only tied now. That one goal is going to be huge. Last game, if you're just tuning in, first period, we had one goal. The whole first period. Game one, we had 10 goals in the first period. It's a wild card what we're going to get here tonight. Speed Chaser here looking to take this one down the near side. Graves there, quick to the challenge for Minneapolis. Ushers the puck back over to Barbecue. Barbecue. Looks to the near side. Speed Chaser takes away that cross ice pass every step of the way. Textbook back checking there for the Provo Polar Bears. Blue with a quick challenge off the forehand. Has a 3-on-1. Passes top side. So that one goes off the corner. Here's Barbecue with it now here from Minneapolis. Wagers his options. Bank pass. Gets it past Speed Chaser. Down low to Bart or Fuico. Fuico looking for the centering feed over to Graves. Top side out to the point. Pass over to Barbecue. Near side. Blue there. Quick to the challenge. Goes ringing that one down corner to corner. A soccer boy just sandwiched between two Minneapolis players. Here's Barbecue with it now. 2:10 to go here in period one of game three. Chase had a chance to steal that burger away. The window was open. The pie smell particles. That's too long analogy. We're going to move on from that. Here's Barbecue. Look at him slap. Here's Graves. Look at him shot. He doesn't want to do it quite yet, but we'll see it later. Here's Barbecue. It's a mouse catool for us. Graves shooting it. Goes off to the near side. Finds Fuico after a short bounce. Looking for that point pass stolen by EJ. Goes off chase and down the full length of the ice. Provo on the back pedal right now. All the momentum out on the ice right now. Feeling the Milk Duds favor. We'll see if they can keep the ice tilted. Fuico wins it away from Speed Chaser. Blue has not had much time with the puck here tonight. Provo has not had much time here tonight with the puck in game three. Off the back end. Nice save. And Blue going to defend that one to the top side wall. Shots 3-1 so far here in the first. Blue just tries to break this one away from Graves. And so far, EJ, topside off the tip of his stick. There's been three times here tonight so far in this series that EJ has had a chance to score, and it just hits the tip of his stick. It's not any fault of his. It's just something that happens. Chase, beautiful catch of the pass. Always able to find that backhand direction on target. Beautiful do-si-do hip check, and that one's going to find a goal. Barbecue from downtown, giving Speed Chaser a little payback from game one whenever he did that from his own side of the ice. There's only been two dump goals so far here this series. We've had a plethora of goals. We had 22 goals in game one. Only one was a dump goal here tonight in game three. One of the two. We'll see if the percentage evens out. Only time will tell. Here's Blue. Not able to get fancy with it. Graves here picking it up down the near side. Fans on it. So that one goes off the forehand. Not able to hit Fuico. Blue to EJ. Top side down low for Provo. Trying to get it from the blue line towards the cage. The centering feed is on. And that one just goes wide as Chase looking to find a way to make his mark here tonight in game three. EJ to Blue. Blue challenged by Fuico quickly. He's going to be forced to retreat. Now one goes off Speed Chaser. Topside corner. EJ trying to pick it up but not able to. Here's Barbecue with it now for Minneapolis. Near side banks it off the wall. Chase takes it away. Off the backhand. Great stick check. Opens it up. And Fuico defended there by Blue. Off to the near side wall. And Fuico takes the puck back to the neutral zone. Down low to Graves. Backhand shot. Blue awarded that block as he takes that one topside to 8:10 to go here in the first. Barbecue looking for Graves. Blue here takes it up off the back and he shoots and scores. Oh my goodness. The man, the myth, the legend. One of the best talents we have here in the SPL. We don't even get to watch the whole replay. They're down to business. They're not taking no for an answer. And they're here to play hockey here tonight. What a game. What a series. What a match so far. 1-2, Provo down for the first time in a long time. I think it's been four periods since Provo's last had to trail against the Milk Duds. Two shots on goal, one of them going in, but on the other side, Minneapolis has found a way to throw a few punches. It feels like we're watching Mike Tyson and Jake Paul right now. I don't know how that match concludes. If you're watching from the future, it hasn't happened yet. Blue with the only goal for Provo. On the other side of the ice, one for Barbecue, one for Fuico, and two for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. We're down on the ice here for the second. Provo on the left side in the teal. The Duds on the right side in the brown. And once again, 5 minutes underway between these two teams here tonight. Minneapolis in this game are in a do-or-die situation. They need this win. They need it now. Will they find it? Blue with the bank pass. Looks for the hand of soccer boy EJ. Going to keep that cycle topside out to Speed Chaser. He centers that feed. Goes off Barbecue over to EJ. EJ. Handles that one back over to Blue. Three goals have been scored. Only one's the gap. Duds on top. Still here in the second. Topside. Chase Poling shooting near side and wide. Here's EJ. For a passing lane to open up. Blue just begging for the puck on the near side point. Chase not able to break that one through. The defense of Minneapolis. Back pass over to Barbecue. They set up shot. They set up the breakout. Gets EJ to bite on that one and finds a little bit of elbow room. Fuico holds it, pulls it, shoots it, scores it. Oh, my goodness. He found a way. I had my doubts.
I don't know how he caught that. It's Stretch Armstrong down low. 3-1's the score. The Duds finding a way to put him up. Not even 60 seconds lapsing in the second. Minneapolis know what they need to do. They need to play up. They can't play down to a team like Provo. Provo are a very, very possessive, heavy team. If they don't have the puck, they don't control the pace of the game. And the Minneapolis Milk Duds know that more than any other team this season in the Masters Division. I don't know what that was. I'm going to be honest with you. Blue just great stick check. Wasn't about it. Was not about it. Here's Chase. Hop the backhand. EJ. Looking out of the near side over Speed Chaser. Chaser hands it off to Blue. Blue here. The most dangerous man with the puck. Not able to tame the beast here tonight. Graves trying to get this one down to Barbecue. Near side over to Fuico. Fuico returns fire back over to Barbecue. They play Hot Potato near side point. Center lane. Nice shot. Goes off Blue. Graves here trying to pick it up, but not able to get the puck to work with him in time. Blue has been the lone denominator so far here this game for the Provo Polar Bears. The only goal, all the saves. He's doing everything he can to carry this corpse towards a victory. And nice shot right there from Blue as well. In this third game, Soccer Boy, Chase, just been they haven't had any room to work with. They haven't been able to create space for themselves. And Minneapolis is just taking full advantage of the pressure, the sheer perseverance they have down there on the ice. They're not going to go away quietly into the night, just like the Independence Day speech. They're gonna fight tooth and nail for everything they can get down there on the playing surface. Graves, dangling, shooting. Nice save there by Blue. That one goes back out through the neutral zone. EJ forehand, not able to get it off the heel. Back out in front. Nice stop there by Fuico. That was going to be forced down low. Back into the Milk Duds territory. Graves to Fuico. Fuico here the now. Shooting. Oh, what a shot. And he makes it 4-1. With 2:14 to go here in the second. Oh, he barely got that one by Blue. He could smell it with his ear. As close as that one was, the burnt rubber just aromiating in the air. I don't think that's how you say it, but that's how I'm going to say it. That's a new word for me. Here's Graves with an out with a shot made. Nice block, and Blue going to defend that one to the near side wall. Here's B. Chaser with an out, the captain of the Polar Bears, to Blue shooting. Nice save there by Fuico. Fuico to Graves to Barbecue. Barbecue from the point back over to Graves. Shooting far side and wide from the corner. Finds its way back out to the outer slot. Here's Blue now with a leading pass. A little too hard there for Speed Chaser. Not quite the shuffleboard pass he was hoping for. Maybe curling if you're from up north. Here's Soccer Boy EJ. Stick checked away by Fuico. Going to send that one back over to Blue. Blue stick checked away by Graves. Graves here looking for the dangle. Oh, what a save by Blue. Guessed it out to the post, and he was able to find a way to keep that one from happening. The man has found 7 saves so far here tonight, and he's earned every single one of them. Here's Blue off the backhand. Chase off the body of Barbecue, almost deflected onto the Minneapolis net, and that would have been a godsend for the Provo Polar Bears to get them back within 2. Barbecue, topside Graves, blocked away there by Blue. Barbecue, Fuico gets fancy with a down low into the corner, hand delivered out to Graves, and Graves just going to muffin that one down center lane. EJ going to fight for it, getting that one as far north as possible. Graves, down low, Barbecue, back over to Graves with 60 seconds remaining here in the second period. 4-1 still our score for Minneapolis. Here's Graves with an out. Forehand shot. Blue there with a deflection. Blue, forehand shooting. Goes off Barbecue. Defends that one across the grain, across the crease. A very dangerous spot to put the rebound. But, hey, if it doesn't burn you, is it really that hot? Blue, EJ, Chase, not able to send it on. That's a heart throb. That man right there, Fuico. Off the back and stopped by Speed Chaser. Not able to get the puck to work with him. 30 seconds remaining. Blue dangling, shooting. Oh, what a save by Fuico. Oh, my goodness. Beautiful, beautiful save. He's got ice in his veins and on his wrist here tonight as Blue takes it down low. Barbecue there stealing that shot away. Here's EJ with an out. Barbecue back in the neutral zone, trying his best to get the puck possession back from Minneapolis. Does so successfully. Oh, Graves just left Soccer Boy EJ in the dust. Absolutely dirty dangle. 4-1 still our score. Shooting, and Blue going to keep it that way as we go into the second intermission with a 3-goal gap, and that shot column has been not looked more lopsided all night. 2 are in the book. 1 more to go here in Game 3. Minneapolis need to hold on to this lead, and they have a lead. The biggest one they've had all series. We'll see if they can keep it going as all 6 parties are ready to rock and all 6 parties are ready to roll. Blue, the lone man out there on the ice, putting it all on the line. We'll see if he can find a way to bring this game back with the help of his 2 men down there on the ice as they defend the left cage. Provo in the teal, and the Duds on the right side in the brown once again attacking to the left. Blue to EJ. EJ to Blue. Blue with a forehand shot. Nice block there in the neutral zone by Fuico. He's going to take that one back down low here for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. 20 seconds into it, a long distance pass there by Barbecue. Not able to tame that one as was in orbit still. Fuico, pass to himself. Takes possession. Goes off. Nice shot there by Graves. Blue just a heavy man to move. Locking that one away to the top side as he takes that one down low. Fuico there finds his way to Graves. Graves trying to bank that one off the side of the cage. Hopefully going to bounce that one out in front. The angle is there off the side of the cage. It's not quite not quite where the puck landed for him on that one. It's more of a spin of the wheel. There's no way you can quite calculate the nanopixels you need for that one. For the few Super Mario 64 runners in chat, it'd be the same as hitting a subframe. Soccer boy EJ here with the now. Down low here for Provo. EJ out to Blue. Blue to Graves. Graves off the back end, looking for a hope and a prayer out to Fuico as he directs that one back over to Barbecue. Takes too much time with it. And Graves somehow hooks that one off the forehand. I've never seen a harder angle pass on the release point of the forehand. Maybe I just don't play controller enough. I don't know. I got a new GameCube controller. I want to see how that works out. Here's EJ. Goes off Barbecue. Barbecue. Forehand shot goes wide off the far side down to the near. Fuico keeping it down low. Blue getting a hand on this one. Forehand pass out to the neutral zone. Barbecue takes it. Blocked away by his teammate, though. Fuico directs that one back out to Barbecue. Fuico. Forehand pass down low. Fuico at the end of the regular season had the third most goals in the regular season with 28. Second to Blue with 33. Carried by Dead not playing tonight for the Oregon Capybaras at 37. Those of you keeping tallies at home, here's Blue with it now. And Graves not able to, he does. Okay, I was going to say, that's the most unfortunate thing I've ever seen in my life. 3:09 left to go here in the second. Man, the third. We're on the third. Oh, my gosh. My whole mentality has changed. It's the second period. Thank you, Cole. I did not notice that. That changed my entire outlook on life. It's like seeing the eclipse for the first time. Somebody said that on local news, and I'm never going to forget that. Fuico, backhand pass at the Barbecue. It got dark outside. I don't know why. I don't know. I'm going to drop it. Here's Fuico. Looking down low. Blue not going to buy anything. He's selling. Goes topside off Graves over to Barbecue. Barbecue, quick under pressure from Speed Chaser. Going to leave it up to EJ to challenge that man. The back check of Provo has just been the same thing since game two. They said it worked one time. It'll work again. The Duds have found a way to pick apart the pieces of the pickled pepper here tonight. They found five. I don't know what they're doing. Provo can't hit the net. They have the same amount of shots as the other team has goals, and that's not a winning formula. You got to find a way to open up the goal scoring column. You got to find a way to just hit the net. Any chance they get with the puck, they got to find a way to put it on target. Chase, backhand. Shot made goes wide. Here's EJ. Out in front. Fuico awarded that save. Goes off to the near side. Don't know if that should count as a shot, but the game's going to game. I'm going to commentate, and players are going to play. Barbecue. The three from Minneapolis with the puck. Looks to the near side. Has the lane for Fuico. Fuico. Forehand shooting. Goes off the body. Off the near side post. Fuico looking to jam it out in front. Great stop there by Speed Chaser. So that one finds his way out to the near side from the point. Red line. Blue. Stopped at the offensive blue line. Is Barbecue going to force him to retreat with this one? Blue. Just trying to get away from the man. Able to get that deke on him. Selling that one for $1.50 at the candy store. Here's Fuico with an out, taking that one right away from EJ as they both had to fight for it. Chase forms a sandwich for Provo as they challenge it down low. Blue off the forehand, backhand, released off the stick of Graves over to Speed Chaser. Tries to pancake that one along the wall over to Blue. Graves almost able to win this one away. He does. Over to Barbecue, top side, looking for Fuico out at the point. Pass somehow finds his way through Speed Chaser. Over to Graves, down low, Fuico. Looking for a shot. Not able to score. And a panhandle save from Blue. Takes it away. Shooting. Almost able to get it to go. Oh, that would have been a thing of beauty. 60 remain here in regulation. The Duds looking to stay alive. Barbecue with a save. That one goes off Blue and wide. Fuico down low. Barbecue holding on to it. A quick challenge for Provo's offense on the back check. Blue playing up. Looking to get a few on the board. Maybe to carry some momentum. And Chase gives his team a chance. They have two. And they need three more. Can they do it? Will they do it? Maybe they'll do it. I don't know. I'm not going to say anything. The caster's curse follows me everywhere I go, in IRL and in the game. I say that too ironically. I caught myself. Here's Soccer Boy. Looking for a backhand feed. Goes off a shot attempt there by Fuico just wide. Here's Blue with an out with 30 seconds remaining with a long distance shot. Goes off Barbecue. Barbecue. From the corner, tries for the backhand feed. Going to loft that one down in favor of Minneapolis. Just going to look to hang on to the lead. No shame in that. It is the playoffs. You take them as they come, you leave them as they don't. Minneapolis finding a way to put the biscuit in the oven five times, maybe six. He just tries to jam his way through the doorstep, not able to get it to go. Great defense there from soccer boy EJ. So we near the end of this one, and that will do it. They still have a chance. They're staying alive like they're the Bee Gees here tonight. 2-5 our score, the Duds on top to bring that series to an ultimate 2-1 gap. And they're playing their hearts out. They're not pulling any punches. And they sure showed us what they can do here tonight with Game 3 under their belts. 5-2, 17-9. Possession time somehow even. I don't know how that one works. Takeaways just about even. Same with passing game. Everything's even except for the shots. It all, statistically speaking, it all came down to Blue. I don't know how that man can put up that stat line. I don't think that was possible. If you were to look statistically at how every position plays and what stats they get, Blue is the anomaly. He has one of the team's 2 goals, 12 of the team's 12 saves, and 13 of the team's 16 takeaways, along with 2 minutes of the 2 minutes and 30 of uncontested puck possession the Provo Polar Bears had here tonight in Game 3. They are going to be talking about that. Hat trick for Fuico. Graves with 1, Barbecue with 1. Beautiful stuff there for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. 6 ready to rock, 6 ready to roll. We're down on the ice here for Game 4. Can you believe it? Duds on the right side looking to stay alive. They have to win again. We're in the brown. Provo Polar Bears looking to close it out in teal, defending left, attacking right. Stopped there by Barbecue. Fuico taking that one down low. Here's Blue with it now. Finds EJ. Out to Chase. Shooting, scoring. And if history has anything to tell us, the Provo Polar Bears win up in the game. They don't lose it. They don't lose it easily. And they don't lose it often. Soccer boy. Been off to the hands of Blue. Blue wearing the championship crown. Changing the fit. Trying to get a new outlook on life here tonight. We'll see if it comes in handy. Soccer boy. Off Fuico. Blue. Taking the monkey backpack near side. Goes off chase over to EJ. EJ backhand down low. Handled there by the pink mohawk himself. Barbecue. So he looks to dice this one up top side. Fuico goes over to Graves. Graves dangling, shooting, goes off Blue and wide. 60 seconds elapsing. 1 goal on the board so far. The first period always seems to have just 1 notch, maybe 2 at most recently. Both of these teams have found their stride against each other. They played 3 times in the regular season, 3 times in the postseason. This is Game 7 here in Season 12 between these two teams. Blue. Off the back end, goes off Barbecue and wide. Here's Fuico in now. 3:34 to go here in the first, 1-0 our score. Looking to equalize it here with this next drive. Off the back end, Blue with a save. Not awarded it, though. Only a block somehow, some way. That's a question scientists will not know the answer to. What's the purple orb made of that Mewtwo uses in Melee? How do you obtain purple flirt? The Jimmy Neutron drink. And how did that happen? Those are the 3 anomalies that scientists will never know the answer to. Blue, top side. Off the forehand, not able to get that one to bank in the air, but not going to be deterred. And Chase just finds a way to send it on target. I don't know what that angle was, how sharp it was, but if it wasn't cheese, it'd be cheddar. Oh, my goodness. Fuico just, he took away the centering pass. You can't blame him for it. But Chase says, I can blame you for it because I put it in. I don't know. I'm just the man that talks into the microphone. That was a mind game and a half there by Speed Chaser. EJ down low, looking for Blue. Blue here with possession for Provo, goes for a bank pass, top side over to EJ. EJ outer slot, looking for that centering feed, look for a head pass. Hopefully bank that one in off Chaser. Here's Graves with a nap for Minneapolis. Top side down by 2. Fuico looks for the feed over to Barbecue. Goes off the stick check, here's Graves with it yet again. Nobody to send it down ice to. He'll retreat this one back to his defenseman Barbecue. Barbecue has the step on the opposition, here's Graves. Graves, forehand, off the body of Chase to the near side point. Here's Fuico, hand delivers that one over to Barbecue. Barbecue shooting, goes off the near side of the cage, and that goes wide. Here's Blue with a now with 2:15 to go here in the first. Provo, looking to claim this championship by force if they have to. And they will. Have to. I'm not going to say they're going to take it, but, you know. EJ. Almost had him the bite on it. Almost got him with it. If that stick-on-stick contact didn't happen, we would have had a different story there. It'd be 3-0 instead of 2-1. Fuico able to find a way to tap that one down memory lane. Blue, great challenge. I like it a lot. The tenacity, the decision, the timing of it all. Fabulous, just unlucky. That's all it boils down to. Little womp-womp moment. The buck 45 remaining here in period one. Blue here with the puck now off the backhand. Goes down low. EJ looking for the centering feed. Goes off. Barbecue and wide. Here's Blue. Looking to get that one off the far side wall. Barbecue not taking no for an answer. He's going to hold the wall. Hold the door. Blue. Forehand. Shot made. Nice block there by Fuico. Sends it to the far side wall. Barbecue there. Almost able to get past EJ. Just smacks him back into Tuesday. My goodness. Fuico. Forehand shot. Defended beautifully there by Blue. I believe was the block of that shot. Blue starting to break out once more, something we've seen time and time again. EJ gets a step and barbecue over to Chase, almost able to get the shot on, hits the tip of the stick instead of the curve of the blade, and that one is not quite the purchase he was hoping for on that one. Fuico near side, barbecue down low. Here's Graves with an now 60 to go. Barbecue looks down center avenue. Was off a few bodies, and in she goes. We're tied up like a hog in a rodeo here in the first 52 seconds remain. And we won't even get to see how it happened. It happened so fast. It's like SpongeBob. You want to see me do it again? Chase, empty cage, and walk it in. It happens. Hat trick for the man, though. Something I didn't really expect to see happening, but it happened. And we'll take it in stride. We'll see what happens. I don't know, man. It's a 2-1-0. The goalposts were the only real say whether or not that shot went in or not. Barbecue off the back end, down low. The first man to it will be Soccer Boy EJ. First time tonight I've seen him as the last man back, which is very strange. The only time I've really seen him play competitive slapshot outside of his West Coast games have been the tournaments. And he plays an immaculate three whenever it comes to blocking shots. Graves looks topside. EJ trying to follow that one back over to Blue. Blue here, the forehand shot goes off barbecue. Now that's the end of period one. 3-2 our score. Provo Polar Bears on top so far here in game four. We're going to close out the series here with this game. They want to go to bed. I don't know. Three shots, three goals. Nobody's been told no so far. Not a save in sight. And the goaltenders have just decided, you know what? Enough of this shutout. We're going to score more than they do. And that's how you win games. I feel like it's pretty equal, easy equation to understand. Is my goal more than their goal? Yes, I win. No, I lose. Second period, ready to rock and roll. Duds on the right side in the brown. Provo on the left side in the teal. Provo up in the series with a game with a championship clinching chance. I fumbled the bag too hard on that one. We're just gonna forget that sentence ever happened. Here's Fuico, off EJ. We're gonna send that one back down low over to Blue. Graves getting a few pieces of contact on him. Blue going to reverse this one down to the near side. A lot of elbow room to work with from that opening. Near side down the straight goes off barbecue. Barbecue off the backhand. Not able to send that feed over to Graves in time. EJ gets it low. Chase picks it up. Sent back over to EJ down low in the corner. Out in front. Blue shooting, scoring. And it's a back to a two-goal lead. Great pass by EJ. Two milk duds caught below their own goal line on the centering feed. And that does not spell much for the defensive efforts. Blue taking this one down low, almost able to dance it out in front. That one's cleared out by Graves. Chase with a pass, barbecue with a stop. Zone goes off to Fuico. Fuico, topside point, shot, nice save by Blue. Zone comes all the way back down to the Minneapolis zone. Barbecue gets a stick check on Speed Chaser, goes off towards that near side. Barbecue finding his way off Graves with a shot attempt. A nice deny by Blue back in the crease. And Fuico is just wreaking havoc on that goal crease right now. Blue takes the possession away, though. Here's EJ. Nobody in the net, and he scores. And he makes it 5-2. And this lead is just growing. It's like the little dinosaur you used to buy in, like, the plastic wrapper. You put it in water, it'd grow. You know what I'm talking about? Am I old? I know the answer to that one. You don't have to tell me. Barbecue. All was able to find Graves with a one-timer, just sitting on the near side goalpost, hoping, praying that the puck would eventually find him. EJ Looking off the backhand, top side, off the bank pass to himself, not able to find the puck to work with him. Barbecue, Fuego looking for the empty cage, off the shot. Nice block there by Speed Chaser. Fuego hoping for that far side post to be kind to him, but we will never know. Barbecue takes it away for the boys in brown, looking down towards that near side. Fuego takes it, shoots it. Oh, what a save by Blue. Barbecue, nice shot, goes off the side of the cage. Fuego, Graves, almost able to corral that one off the hip. And he's not feeling all that super-duper here tonight. Barbecue looking to get them back within two. Nice shot off the side of the cage. Blue awarded that save. They're just looking to get the puck, throw it on target. Not a bad idea. Not a bad idea at all. Every time the puck hits your stick, if you throw it on the goal, you will win a lot of slapshot games, whether it's an SPL game or a pub game. If you can just hit the net from anywhere, anytime, anyhow, do it. I dare you. I double dare you. I'm double dipping right now into these blue goals. Look at them go. Look at how many he's scored tonight. Is that 14? It has to be at least 14 goals for him. There's no way it's not. That man's a fiend. He's a demon on ice. It's like Disney. Anyway, Fuego, where did that save? Goes off to the top side, looking to break this one down low over to Barbecue. Barbecue, backhand, goes off, blue and wide to the near side corner, finds his way back out to the point. Fuego goes off the end wall over to Barbecue, but off the end wall again to Graves. Graves looking for his chance near side, and he's going to rail that one back down into the defensive zone. Indianapolis here starting out with the puck. Fuego over to Graves. Graves off the backhand, not able to get the stick back on the ice. I feel like he's just playing too fast. He's a little frazzled. Graves not feeling like himself. What we saw him in game one I felt was pretty spectacular. I felt like that if that was the 10 of Graves, he's at like a 6 right now. I think he's just too anxious. His nerves are getting too under his skin right now, right here. But I can't blame him. It's the championship game. It's do or die for his boys down there on the ice, and they're down by 4. I don't blame him at all. Blue. Taking this one down towards the near side. Looking for the cross-ice pass over to EJ. EJ pulling, shooting, goes off the side of the cage and wide. Fuego there takes that one right away. Off the backhand, looking for Graves. Goes off chase. Barbecue will take it up. 1:14 to go here in the second. Backhand shot goes wide off to the near side. Here's Graves with it now. Barbecue goes off EJ. Fuego. Looking to dance with it. Goes off the backhand, off the side of the cage over to Graves. Graves with 60 seconds remaining here in the second. Barbecue here trying for the top side of the ice. And it goes in. I don't know how. It just found its way through the crowd. And Barbecue getting the lone goal here in the middle chapter of play. Off the very edge of Soccer Boy EJ, just enough to deflect that one on target. And hey, little puck luck going a long way right now. Maybe that's the one to break the Campbell's back here tonight. Let's let the duds come back into the race. 46 remains here in the second. Shot, nice save, goes off Blue. Here's Graves with it now, out in front. Fuego, shot made, another save by Blue. Blue to EJ, down low in the corner, crawls that one back to the point. Chase getting that one off the tip of the stick over to Blue near side at his own point. Lobs this one down low with 30 seconds remaining. Here's EJ at the enemy end wall. Sends this one to the top side point. Chipped back towards the cage by Chase over to EJ. Not able to get that one through Fuego, though. Here's Graves with 20. Graves, top side barbecue. Shooting, nice save there by Blue. And he's going to send this one back out to full 200. Minneapolis putting the gas on. Trying to build this fire up to as much as it can be right now. They got a little bit of momentum to work with. Graves here breaks free off the forehand, shooting, and Blue not missing. His hands might be shaking, but he's still hitting headshots. Oh my goodness. 6-3 the score. Provo. Blue standing on his head. He's carrying the boys on his back. 12-8, but the score says otherwise. Provo leading it with a deficit of shots. And Blue, 9 of the team's 9 saves. This man's doing everything he can. He's doing everything he can. 6 ready to rock, 6 ready to roll. Back down on the ice here for the second. Minneapolis defend right in the brown. Provo defend left in the teal. I saw somebody in chat ask if Cole gets the rewards. He played at half. You have to play 50% of the regular season, 50% of the playoffs, or just play a single period in the finals to get end of season rewards. Cole's done that. He played 6 of the 12. He's fine. Graves. Shooting, scoring! And we have a 2-goal gap. 13 shots into it. They're finding a way to crack the ice. That is the stonewall on defense. And Blue thought he could lay back. He thought he could just take up the most of the net and make the save. This time, Minneapolis find a way to find just a gap in the armor. It's very small, very tight, but they found it. Just like David with his sling, he can find a kill. Top side, Fuego. off the backhand. Nice save there by Blue, hugging that topside post for dear life, and he comes out with a save because of it. Here's Barbecue off the hip of EJ over to Graves. Graves here dangling, shooting, goes off, chasing wide. Here's Blue with a now, dances out, goes off Graves, topside over to Speed Chaser. With 4:16 to go here in the third period. 10 goals into it, 2 is the gap. And the Provo Polar Bears, the defending champions, right now on top. EJ, topside, chase down low, off the shot, nice block by Barbecue. 2-on-2 here with Graves, with a shot, goes wide off the far side. I'm sorry, Doobie. What do you got out? Blue. EJ. Wico. We're going to take this one out from Minneapolis. Taking a lot of time to weigh his options. Now, didn't really have a whole lot of options there. His teammates weren't really moving around. But Barbecue taking this one topside. Wico off the backhand. Shot wide. Here's Graves. To the point. Barbecue. Down low to Graves from the goal line. Tries to break it out in front. EJ throws it out in front. Chase keeping that one wide. Goes off the handle. And oh, my goodness. You can't hold a candle to this, man. Oh, my gosh. What a shot. Oh, that was pretty. Oh, I stuck that one on the fridge, Mom. Beautiful, beautiful hockey. Oh, my goodness. Here's Blue with a now. Topside off the wall. Down low to Chase. Chase from the corner. Back to the point. Shooting. Nice save there by Barbecue. Keeping his team alive. And they're playing their hearts out right now. Oh, my goodness. Here's Barbecue. 3:12 to go here in the third. Off, I was on the forehand. The server's a little bit behind. It just does that sometimes. Barbecue saw it as it was, not as we saw it. Fuico getting a piece of that one. Barbecue back at the point. Fuico off the backhand. Goes off Speed Chaser over to Graves. Graves dangling. Oh, that was beautiful. Just the release wasn't quite what he wanted. EJ goes off Barbecue almost on his own net, but almost doesn't count in this game. Chase out in front, nobody there to tuck at the bed. Here's Graves with a now with a leading pass to Barbecue that does not connect. Here's Blue with a now down low behind his own goal line, leans topside, then to the near, uses one dash. Barbecue knows it as he tries to get a few stick checks in there. Able to make a few pieces of contact, but not able to walk away with possession as Blue's going to dump this one down and into the Minneapolis zone. Here's Fuico with a now for the boys in brown, 2:27 to go here in the third. They got one goal to make up. It's anybody's ball game right now. Barbecue going off soccer boy EJ. Barbecue, near side, ringing that one down to the near. Graves there, returns fire, back over to Barbecue. Barbecue here with an out, over to Graves, back in, off the body, almost able to set it in. Fuico just hoping, praying that there was going to be a piece of contact that gave him a chance, and it did. But Blue, simply just a brick wall back there. Another save out in front, and that's swatted away. Here's Graves, 2 minutes to go, one goal is needed to stay alive in the championship. In the Pacific Cup Finals. Graves topside, stolen by Blue. Backhand out in front. Graves with a save off the post. DJ's shot goes wide. Oh, man. They're just playing. They're playing for chips right now. Fuico topside, shooting off the post. Fuico gets the rebound. Is that one careens down low off the end wall? Blue there with a cross-ice pass over to Chase. Goes for a shot. Not able to get that one on target. A little too soft as Barbecue is able to back check into it. Off the forehand, stolen by Chase, goes off to EJ. Fuico getting a piece of that one, applies that pressure. Blue down low, EJ from the point, trying to get this off the hands of Graves. As a nice pick is set, nice save made there by Blue. Here's Blue with a now, saving the majority of 19 shots. My goodness. Graves, Deacon, shooting, nice save by Blue, and that one comes out. Barbecue gets the stick check on Speed Chaser. 64 seconds remain in the season. Barbecue. What will he do? He'll pass it. Fuico has to chase after it as it was off the top of his stick. And that one passes out, goes past Speed Chaser and down the full length of the ice. 50 seconds remain. Here is Barbecue. Barbecue looking for the pass over to Graves. Takes the shot instead. Stolen away by Speed Chaser. And that's going to be lofted out by EJ. 39 seconds remain here in the third. Before it's all over. Fuico pulling, shooting. Far side and wide. Blue. Goes off the Barbecue, out in front. Fuico going to leave it for Graves. Graves falling, shooting. Nice save by Speed Chaser. 27 to go in regulation. Barbecue, the first man to it. Going to take it off the backhand. Shooting goes off EJ. Chase going to clear it out with 20 to go. Graves, the first man back from Minneapolis. They need one. Off the backhand. Barbecue catches it on target. Nice block by Blue. Blue going to take it away. Topside. Chase off the face of Barbecue. Sends it out to Fuico. Fuico one-on-one. Bank pass to himself. Over to Graves. Graves shooting near side and wide. Oh, that would have done it. But it's over. Oh, my goodness. Oh, what a series. What a match. And what an ending. All the way to the end, the Minneapolis Milk Duds have nothing to hang their heads about. 9 shots, 2 goals. Fuico played an insurmountable game for the Minneapolis Milk Duds. one of the top goal scorers coming out of their cabinet, and he did not disappoint in games 1, 3, and 4. But they got 21 shots on goal, and they could not crack the Rubik's Cube that is Blue. That is immaculate, untapped, just beautiful slap shot from the Provo Polar Bears there in game 4. And I cannot think of a better team to go back-to-back between Soccer Boy EJ, Blue, Speed Chaser, and Pediatric Patrick as your Season 12 Pacific Cup champions. 2 minutes with a puck on their stick. They did not need the majority. 62 passes. They did not need the majority. But they won the faceoffs just like the rest of the series, and they won the takeaway game just like the rest of the series. But 16 saves. How much you want to bet they were all Blue? How much you want to bet cash money dollar sign that they were all Blue? Because I'm willing to bet my house. Not really. Because I was very close to losing my house there. 15 out of the team, 16 saves. Speed Chaser, the only other man to play defense out there, had a hat trick and an absolutely stellar performance by Blue. There's no way he's not the MVP for the playoffs. There's no way. There's no way on the face of this planet that Blue is not the MVP of this playoffs. He carried in the fourth game. He carried in the third game. And if he was not on the ice, I do not think Provo would have won this championship. Absolutely beautiful stuff down there. And now comes the part where I don't know if I have a scene set up for the interview. So we'll see what happens. Great stuff on the other side of the ice as well. 2 for Fuico, 2 for Graves, 1 for Barbecue for the total of 5 from Minneapolis. But if this is where you sign off, you don't want to listen to the post-game press conference, thank you for tuning into the SPL Network. My name is Darth Taxil. And if you like what you see, follow. If you like it even more, subscribe. I don't really care if you subscribe, but if you feel like it's worth it, go for it. We have like 3 emotes. Whatever. Up to you. I'm not a number man. I don't need the money. But if you want to do it, it's up to you. Have a good night. But if you are sticking around, I can't type and talk at the same time. If the winning team is in the chat, the stage is set. Just join in. We'll get you going. Do I have a scene for this?
Hello, Mr. Darth.
Hello there. Congratulations.
What's up?
That was spectacular.
I carried for real.
Shout out, Pat.
Let's go, baby.
Yeah, no,
Pat. I'm D1 bench warmer. Bench warmer.
Pat's comms? Greatest thing ever.
Kept his calm.
We love it. That's what we needed.
Do I not have
this? Oh my god, I see Ron. Hi, Ron. Oh, Ron left.
Damn.
So I want to start off with a question, because I feel like my questions are more important than theirs. What happened in game 2? That first period, there's only a goal. What was the mindset change in the locker room?
You know, I forgot what happened in game 2. I'm not going to lie.
low scoring, especially early on. I don't remember either. I feel like they just...
What was the score of game 2?
Passive.
Did we win game 2?
Yeah,
oh, we did.
Yeah, we won game 2, and then we lost game
3.
Won
the first 2-3, and then won third.
I don't remember the score of game 2, but I know it was low scoring.
Game 2.
At least the first few periods. I think they just, like, started playing a little more defensive.
Yeah, I think everybody was just kind of, like, feeling each other out a little.
Just kind of chilling. Like, I feel like we felt confident with where we were at, even though it was low scoring. Like, I feel like we felt pretty good that game.
Yeah.
We didn't have to, like, overcommit anything. Just, you know, keep working it around. Eventually something will break, and then they'll start overcommitting a lot, and we'll get more goals.
Yeah, so starting the first period out, we had, what, 10 goals in the first period? You want to take me through that?
Dude,
yeah.
EJ was locked in.
Yeah, EJ was hitting everything. I loved it. It was beautiful.
I think EJ had a hat trick in the first period, if my memory serves.
Yeah,
right.
No, I think you're correct.
That sounds right.
Yeah, good stuff. All right, Tavik, first hand raise I see.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
No.
Anybody but him.
How's it going?
So,
hey, Blue! So, Blue! Oh.
So, Saki. So, Soccer Boy, you know. You know, you're just the best player ever. Oh, my gosh.
I don't know about
I meet
that.
Ride you every day.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. I do.
Toby, you trying to 1v1.
Wait, who's this guy?
The guy who's beat you like actually 200 times in a row.
9-10?
I beat you so many
Rocky
times.
Boy, gosh. 20-0 me every day, every game. Such a good player.
That's a great question.
All right, thank you for the question. I think I actually. I did not mean to do that, but.
Should they get Nair there?
Yeah, Nair has
yes, Nair.
Hello.
Hello, Nair. Hi, Nair.
What's up, Nair?
I'm good. So I don't know nothing about West, but I just want to say congratulations to y'all for winning West.
Thank you, Nair.
It means a lot coming from you.
I love you, Nair. My favorite French person.
Yeah, you're the only cool one. All the other ones are pretty lame.
Yeah.
Damn.
Especially that Crooks guy or whatever his name is now, Cajun.
Cajun. So did you guys have anything like special for your pregame? Did you guys get hyped up? You do smelling salts?
Yeah.
No performance enhancing drugs were used at all.
Yeah, none at all. None at all.
I didn't take
anything. Nah, there was absolutely no funny business whatsoever.
Yeah.
Purely
locked
in
the locker room, you know, getting the needles and shit.
Only drinking water and Gatorade. And then, yeah, that's it.
Love to hear
nothing
it.
Else.
Love to hear
absolutely.
It. All right, Nair, you had another negative knowledge.
Back. Is there any way I could get a jersey of the Provo Polo Bear?
I something up.
In that's real life.
Yeah.
I would go down to buy one if it's not too expensive.
Okay.
I'll look into it.
We'll hook you up, Nair.
We'll talk to the media team here for Provo.
Good.
Yeah.
We can do.
I think the only other teams we've seen that have actual like merch was what the Typhoons and Cowtown.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe the Tokyo Ghouls. I could see that being a possibility.
Yeah, probably.
that would make sense.
I can't back that one up, but
we tried.
I don't know if I would want that, but.
The Orcas, yeah, the Orcas had merch.
Oh, Orcas did have merch.
Oh, yeah, they did.
Thank you, Fuico.
That's crazy.
Win pucks tomorrow. Maybe, I don't know. It's up
to
Johnny.
Wait, actually tomorrow? I'll go bug Johnny. I gotta do it every time.
Yeah.
Even though he stopped responding to me.
Yeah, dude, like season 10, I didn't get my rewards until the playoffs for next season.
That is crazy.
Yeah.
That is wild.
That is absurd. Oh, if we could just decide to join. You could just join. How's it going, Fuico?
There we go.
What's up, dude?
Doing it all official.
GG's, boys.
GG's.
A fun series.
Blue, bro.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, bro. That movie, dude, where you just hit people and you just get the fucking biggest speed boost of all time.
Oh, yeah.
It makes no sense.
Dude, I couldn't do
I
it against
they, I hope they patch that shit, bro. I hope they patch that shit.
It's not a patch. It's just me bumping you.
No, bro. You get the wickedest speed glitch I've seen.
Nah, it's not it's even like, a it's speed like glitch. I just bump
bro,
you, dude. I'm just big.
I'll give you that. I'll give you that the big, but once again, GG's, boys.
Yeah, GG's.
I'm playing.
It was a good time.
Sucks, but oh well. I got to take the loss on the chin.
Unfortunate.
Right. What other question do I have? That's about it. GG's.
GG's.
Stuff. I don't know if you guys remember this. In game 3, I think it was game 3, like first period, Blue had the puck behind his net, and he bumped away, I think, Barbecue, and everything just stopped for, like, 5 seconds.
I think it was a server lag.
Yeah.
It was a server lag? Okay.
Yeah, the server changed. It was just strange, but yeah, I guess I caused everybody to lag with that bump. That's my bad.
It went to, like, the LA server.
Yeah, the server just switched
randomly.
To, like, LA.
Yeah, in the middle of the game.
Yeah, and that's crazy. I haven't played on the LA server in, like, 4 months.
I didn't know
it still existed.
Yeah. It's like LA or San Jose or something.
I was like 14 thing. I was like, this
oh, it might be San Jose.
Was
yeah.
On 40.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, I popped up to 34, but it just felt so bad. I don't know.
Yeah, it did fine. Feel kind of choppy, even though I had lower ping. But
yeah.
It's, super
it's classic West. Nothing ever goes right.
True.
I don't even know why it switched because there's 3 people queuing West.
Yeah. It's not like it overloaded or was too popular.
Yeah, no. I don't get it. Do a yellow derv.
Bring back the Seattle server, says Fuico.
And bring back both of them.
Aren't those still up?
I don't think I ever played on those. So. No, because we took a poll on which server we wanted.
I thought they were in San Jose and Washington.
Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know. I think he changed the server locations when he did the new servers.
Yeah, probably.
So I got a question for Blue. How does it feel to be once again top of the top, most chips in West again?
You know, that's really what I wanted. You know, I'm sorry for you, Co. I didn't want to pick you up because I wanted this, but yeah, it's pretty great. It feels good.
I got a question for Darth. We're not getting any crowns for this.
So the rule I've been going with is after 5 West chips, you get the crown. If we could got his last season, last chip. So I think Graves is at 4, Kylar is at 3.
Hug it up, Darth.
Am I allowed to donate a crown?
No.
Please.
I think Cole's at 3 as well now.
Yeah, I think so.
He's at 2. No, he's 2.
No, he's at 2, yeah. The numbers are getting up there.
Yeah.
Sir.
Wes is just popping. I don't know.
Yeah, been around for a while, a long time. I hope.
Oh, I got a question. Oh, yeah, sorry. Go on.
No,
I was just going to say, are we going to go back to like one division or?
I don't know. That's what I was going to say. I really hope that Wes stays where it's at right
who
now.
Who signs up?
Yeah.
It's not bad right now.
I don't know. I think all the duds are retiring or they might come back.
Yeah.
And try and get barbecue crown. I don't know.
They're pissed now. They're gonna come back with vengeance.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah. These might also not come back.
So you guys feel all right with like how did you guys feel all right with how the season was formatted with the three times the three round robin?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was good. Season. It was fine. Yeah.
All right. Because we might do that again next season. Because if we have 10 teams, we can do 5 and 5.
Yeah. Just run the same. No, it was good. And honestly, like even some weeks it felt pretty light. Like we would only have like one game some weeks, so it was chill. It was pretty good.
Yeah, it was nice.
Have we got a few questions in the audience?
We do.
We got Graves.
Oh, we got Nair back. Let's go.
What's up, Nair?
What's up, Nair?
What's up, man?
You're good. Yeah. How did you to be like pretty good? How did you do to be as good on West? To be as East.
Facts, Nair. You spoke the biggest facts, bro.
No, EJ, I actually understood that. Hold up.
I only got like West out of that. I'm sorry.
He asked, how did I get good on West and East? Like, playing on both. I don't know. When I started on West, just build it. Now the ping fucking helps because I'm on central. So like I get mid ping like kind of everywhere. But I mean, season one, I would queue with Jake Drips. Big shout out to him. He doesn't exist anymore. He's just
hot. I thought he played 2 seasons ago.
Did he?
He's been around. Last I remember
actually
paying attention.
Yeah, damn, I've not seen him.
I remember.
I've not seen him in a while. No, I queued with him like every day on East, and we're just like, yo, let's randomly get good at East just so we can play. Because like we were queue at like some weird ass times when nobody was on West, but like there were a couple people on East so we'd still get games.
Yeah.
And then
how much ping do you have on East?
On East I get anywhere from like 46 to 56 now.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, no, I mean it used to be horrible. I was on like 80
on, 100. On West I have like 90.
Yeah, that's brutal.
Yeah, that's.
I still can do clips on people.
Yeah. I mean, because you're a controller, right?
No, and then keyboard and mouse.
Oh, how the.
Oh, that's terrifying.
That's actually crazy.
How do you? That shit's light work. Y'all don't. It's light work.
Yeah, is it?
It's light work.
Hi, buddy. Hi, buddy.
Hi, so. Congratulations again.
Yo, thank you, Nair.
Thank you, Nair.
Thank you for your time,
Nair. I'm capping, bro. I'm ass on East.
Right,
I've played you on East. It's great.
Tough, dude. It's so hard.
How you doing,
Graves? What's up, Graves?
Yeah. What's up, Graves?
No, I was just coming to say GG's, bro.
Yeah, GG's, man.
GG's.
Good shit.
Serious.
You robbed
also,
me.
I don't.
But listen,
oh.
Hear me out here. All right. If you didn't get that board bounce thing, we would have been game five.
Yeah, that was actually crazy.
Real game changer.
I'm fucking with you. But nah, GG's for
honestly, that was the most fucked up thing. Because, I mean, you guys were already down by five, and then you get even more unlucky.
So hard.
Yeah.
I was debating giving you a goal.
Didn't fucking
it was the unluckiest thing I've ever seen.
That would have pissed me off so much.
Dude, it just, luck wasn't in our favor, but, I mean.
Yeah, now we're playing it is good. What it is.
GG's.
Yeah, that was a good series.
Yeah, GG's, Graves.
GG's.
Ron wants to know how much blue lifts.
Like, I mean, for what?
I don't know.
I mean, that's like a very fucking basic thing, Rom. I don't know. I lift like 3 times Crusade's body weight every day before the game. It's definitely up there. Yeah, no, it's always, I base my units of Crusade instead of like pounds or kilograms or shit. But, I mean, it's just such a good unit.
It's a universal, like, understanding unit.
Yeah. Like, everybody knows that he's 400 pounds, so, like, it's okay. Yeah.
Everyone knows what it means to them. That's enough.
Yeah. That's we're good.
All right. Well, I think that's...
You want to try and get Kale up here?
Does Kale want to...
Kale, you want to come up?
Kale, come on up.
A few words.
Stonewall.
Let's go, Kale. Come on, Kale.
You're on the spot, man. We're all looking at you.
Yeah.
We're getting peer pressured up here.
Speech.
Speech.
Lame.
Boring.
Oh, he's gone.
He left.
Oh, wow.
You got a little shy.
Nah, I'm going to go get so much shit for that.
That's crazy.
Yo, Darth, so before the series started, you said this could be like one of the best.
I was looking at the
West.
Rosters, and the two rosters tonight were like the most equally skilled I've ever seen West. Because every West Finals I've casted, it feels like it's an outright winner every time.
Yeah, no.
This was like
you kind of know it was just gonna win that.
Yeah, like last season, you guys, what who'd you guys play against?
Oh EJ. Well, okay, let's not.
Yo,
let's
EJ
not.
EJ got shit on.
Yeah, that.
Yeah.
Player EJ.
I felt bad for Capybaras. But
yeah, we stomped that EJ guy.
It was rough. And then the season before that, it was Barbecue Cole, Fuico, and Graves versus like Pat Hex,
That's
Milk, and Dynasty.
It was me. Was it was me, worst. Hex, and fucking Dynasty. Yeah.
Season 9.
Bro, we went into that series just being like, all right, put in as many as we can before we lose.
just gotta walk away with it.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, season 9 was like strange. Yeah.
Can we make a rule where Blue and Frico can't be on the same team like ever again?
Like, I mean, if they want to make that rule, the division will be as interesting as
that. Hey, if they make that team, I got to be on the bench. That's fair.
Well, I feel like you have to play.
You got to be playing, yeah.
Yeah, I think you got to be playing.
We'll see. Personally, I don't know. I would want to make that rule, but as the league, we've never held that rule before, so we're not going to do it.
Yeah.
I mean, the rule book's always updating, and, you know.
I mean, West can always just revolt again like they did season 2 or 3 with the fucking Maui Monkeys.
Yeah, didn't you guys do like, you almost did a draft league once, like unofficially.
Yeah, because me, Kylar, and Hot Wing kind of ruined the league for a little bit.
Yeah, that was back when Zay was around.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder what happened to him.
Who knows?
He just disappeared, vanished. I think he still owns the West Coast Discord.
Actually?
I think he's still the owner of it. I don't know if he ever gave that back, because he just kind of went radio black, and I think he deleted everything.
Oh, we've never. Yeah, maybe. It. I don't know. Oh, somebody said Messiah was in the chat today.
Yeah, Messiah.
Yeah, yeah, he was in the chat.
Is that a true thing? I have not seen that man in so long.
See, I think it'd be dope if we could bring
it's
back
crazy.
All the season 2 OGs.
Yeah, bro.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all team with Tyler.exe again.
Like, mid-season 8, like, everybody that played the game on West just fucking disappeared.
Yeah.
Sad, man.
We gotta get Lil Q back. Yeah, Rambone.
And I love Lil Q.
Wiki.
Babu.
Yeah, Babu.
Jeezy.
You guys remember
dude, we need Toad back. We need Toad.
Yeah.
I miss Toad, bro.
Where's Rambone at? That's my man.
I know, dude. Oscar is my goat. I miss that guy.
Tovik has another question to ask.
All right, last two. Tovik, you're up first.
So, Chaser, you're such a good player, bro. So I was just wondering, like, how'd you get there, you know?
Yeah, buddy. A lot of time and effort. You know.
So who's this blue guy?
This is my best friend since season guy? One.
Yeah, I think he's holding the microphone for Darth.
Yeah, when Chase hated me.
Yeah. Yeah, me and Blue had beef like season one.
And we had beef. It was so
and
dumb.
And Blue was like, "You'll like me one day, trust." And I was like, "Nah."
And then he's gonna drop Blue. Darth.
What's that?
Huh?
So when are you gonna drop Blue?
Abba D, Abba Die?
Yeah. Oh no, I'm in Chaser because he's a captain.
Oh my god, ACCBDD. Oh my god.
Yeah, Akbud.
Akbud. Akbud.
I gotta go.
All right, I gotta go to sleep. His mom's calling him.
Yeah, bro. You gotta do homework.
Editor!
Hey, Nair's back! Let's go!
This time I have something to say to Dart.
So,
okay.
What's going to happen with the Central?
It's the same thing as West, except Central.
But yeah. So well does said. It have only one Central, or it's
as
like
many
Eve?
As sign up. Ideally.
So there's not going to be Pro, Charl, it's only going to be Central.
No, we'll have divisions. It depends on how many people sign up, is how many divisions we get.
I mean, it seems like there's going to be a good amount of teams that sign
up. Oh, yeah,
up.
I think it might have more than East.
Yeah, it could.
I feel like a lot of people
Now, like, everybody can play.
Well, that was all for me. Congratulations again.
Thank you, Nair.
Bye.
You're so fucking handsome.
Bye,
and by the way, Nair. Blue, am I your Frenchie, favorite Frenchie?
Yes, you are. By far.
Yay!
Nobody comes close.
Bye.
See you, bye, Nair.
What a cool guy.
I love Nair.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah. I think it's all the more time we got. I'm going to go to bed. All right. Let you guys go.
Yep. Yo, thank you for
casting.
Thank you for the stream.
Thanks for playing. That was a beautiful series.
So, yeah, thank you. It was fun.
I will hopefully see you again.
Yeah.
Up here for East.
Hopefully.
Hopefully
we'll see you guys back season 13, which starts in like a week and a half or whatever it is.
Really?
That's
wild.
Preseason's the 22nd. Then the week after, that's the regular season.
I gotta see, because I have like a family trip that might take place during playoffs, so I don't know yet.
Yeah, I have everything like marked out on the website. If you go,
yeah, I have to take a look at that.
Like under the league info drop down on the nav bar.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I penciled it out so we finished a season like right before like first week of December, with like a week off for Thanksgiving. So hopefully it all works out and nobody goes to Europe in the middle of playoffs.
This time it might be Japan, if I'm being honest.
Understand.
Yeah.
Japan's dope.
I mean, I don't know who you were talking about with that one.
Nah, some guy back in the day. I don't remember what his name was.
Yeah, some random.
Yeah.
This would be one.
That's true.
Would have been kind of embarrassing if we lost.
All right, boys, time to go spam open tickets in the Slapshot Discord until they give us rewards.
Yep.
Good idea.
I'm not allowed to legally comment on that, but do what you gotta do.
No, nobody will know, Darth.
Take them all.
Keep safe. Darth told us to.
Yeah, bro.
Sure, go for it. Say that.
I'll clip it, brother.
yep. He gave us permission.
Yeah, congrats.
They asked me to stop. I'm playing.
Yeah, anyway, thank you.
Yeah,
thank you, Darth. Thank you for casting.
Yep.
And,
peace out.
Yeah.
Have a good night. Good rest of your night, man.
Yep. Good night. How do I stop this?
I think everyone can leave. I don't know.
There it is.
Yeah.
All right. See you.
Can we just leave? All
right. Bye.
All right. That's all we got for today. And does this work? Are we going to see? It doesn't work. I don't understand. Why doesn't it work? This is so stupid. Why does it? I've worked so hard to make this work, and it just won't. Do you know how many hours I've spent on this streaming setup, and it just won't do the thing that I want it to do? It's so dumb, it's stupid, and quite frankly, I think it's the worst thing that's ever happened. There we go. It works now. We got highlights. Look at that. Look at that. Highlights from the stream. Look at that. Isn't that crazy? Wow. It's like we're a professional broadcast. Oh, man. Look at us go. I don't know what that clip is, but we're going to pretend like it's not real. Is this the VOD? That's the VOD. That's just the VOD. There we go. We got highlights from the stream. Look at it go. Wow, it's crazy. Oh, my gosh. Anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for hanging out. Thank you for watching some Slapshot with me. FKNPRKR, thank you for the 100 bits. Hope you're having a great day. That game wouldn't have been quite as exciting if it weren't for the incredible commentary. Class, my friend, class. Thank you very much. I appreciate that more than you know. That's what keeps me going in the day. That's what wakes me up in the morning. That's what puts me in bed at night. I appreciate you. I think it's just one replay. Is it really just one replay? It's just the one goal. And then Graves' goal. That was pretty. That was a great shot. That was nice. So look at that. Let's watch that one again. Oh, it's so... yeah. Oh, it's great. Rominator, thank you for the 29 bits. Feels good, man. Rominator, 25 bits again. Thank you for that. Live track with the 29 months and strong. Hope you had a great day. Hope you enjoyed the stream. And all the big names in red, Irvion, Eli, JSTronics, Min Snowda, the former league admin herself, Gubby, former league admin MDub, current league admin Unglued Snail, Main, Q Silver, Laugh Track, Davo, and Cheese Pup. Appreciate all your continued support. But yeah, that's it for the West Coast. We until season 13 starts up. That is all that she wrote. But pro playoffs still have to take place tomorrow. The semifinals between the Long Island Lightning and the other team that they play will be taking place there. I think it's the Astoria Hellhounds. That was going to be a great matchup. And winner goes on to play the Miami Vice for the Irvion Trophy. That's a later problem. That's tomorrow at 9 o'clock, if I'm not mistaken. It might be 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Yeah, hope you guys had a great eclipse this last weekend. Hope you guys enjoyed the stream. And see you next time. But for now, thank you for tuning into the SPL Network. My name is Darth Hexil, and I hope you all have a great afternoon, a great evening, and a great night.
One, two, three, one, two, three, two.